Today we are going to learn about the structures that forming the stomach bed, where the stomach lie. Okay, so we know that on the posterior surface there is a lesser sac is present on behind the stomach, and behind that lesser sac we can see so many structures. So today it is a simple topic, so it's very easy to learn. Okay. So first I'm going to draw the stomach. Okay. So here I have drawn a rough figure of a stomach, and we have to draw the duodenum. Okay. In this we can see only the second part and the first part. Okay, we all know that from the second part of the duodenum the pancreas is attached. Okay, so this is the duodenum, and from this part we can draw the pancreas. Okay. So this is the pancreas. After that we have to draw the transverse colon of the large intestine. Okay, that forms one of the structure of the posterior inferior surface, that is a one of the relation of the stomach. Okay, which is present on the posterior inferior surface. Okay. Transverse colon of the large intestine is actually in a U-shaped manner. Okay. After that we can draw the haustrations. Okay. So now I have been completed the transverse colon of the large intestine, and after that we have to draw the mesocolon. Mesocolon is nothing but it is the horizontal fold of peritoneum that suspends the that will suspend the transverse colon of the large intestine from the posterior abdominal wall. So this is the transverse mesocolon. Okay, after that we have to draw the spleen. We all know that the spleen is present here. Okay. One of the important thing I would like to mention you that this is the spleen. The thing is that all the structures present on the posterior surface of the stomach, which is separated by the lesser sac, but the spleen, which is separated from the stomach by the greater sac. Okay. After that, we can draw the abdominal aorta. From this abdominal aorta, the celiac trunk is arising. Okay. From that celiac trunk, we can see it is one of the branch, that is the splenic artery, which supplies the spleen. Okay. After that, we can draw the kidney. Above the kidney, we can see the suprarenal gland. So this is the diagram of the relations of stomach on the posterior surface. So we can label the structures that is present. Okay. So first I am going to label the diaphragm. Here we can see the diaphragm. So the first structures that forming is the diaphragm. After that, we can see the spleen. Okay. So the second relation is the spleen. We know that spleen is present on the left side. So this is the left kidney. Left kidney. If this is the left kidney, then this will be the left suprarenal gland. This is the left colic flexure, and we have the this one is the splenic artery, and we have the transverse mesocolon, and the last one is the transverse colon. Okay, and we have the last one is the body of pancreas. So these are the structures that forming the bed of the stomach: diaphragm, spleen, left kidney, suprarenal gland, splenic artery that supplies to the spleen, body of the pancreas, transverse mesocolon, and we have the structure, this transverse colon, which is present on the posterior inferior part. Okay, so these are the structures that forming the stomach bed. Thank you.